Welcome back to the gross anatomy of muscles of upper limb. Here comes part 2. In this part, we will learn about the muscles of scapular region and deltoid region. So let's start learning. We will begin with the muscles of scapular region. Scapular region, it is located around the scapula. Here is its ventral view and here is the dorsal view. It consists of 5 muscles. Ventrally it shows only one muscle, that is subscapularis. On the dorsal side it shows 4 muscles. From above downwards they are supraspinatus, infraspinatus, teres minor and teres major muscles. Let's learn each muscle in detail. Subscapularis. Here it is. It is the only muscle seen on the ventral aspect of scapular region. It takes origin from medial 2/3 of subscapular fossa on the costal surface of scapula. The muscle fibers converge laterally and they get inserted onto the lesser tubercle of upper end of the humerus. When the muscle contracts, it causes medial rotation and adduction of the arm at shoulder joint. Let's understand this by looking at the following video clip. Here is the scapular region around the scapula. Here is the subscapularis muscle on its ventral aspect. Here is its site of origin and insertion. It is the powerful medial rotator of the arm. Now let's see its nerve supply. Here is the axilla seen from anteriorly after removal of pectoral region muscles. Here are the muscles forming posterior wall of the axilla. They are subscapularis, teres major and latissimus dorsi. 3 muscles receive nerve supply from the posterior cord of brachial plexus. Subscapularis supplied by 2 nerves. They are upper subscapular nerve and lower subscapular nerve. Now let's quickly revise the details of subscapularis muscle. It takes origin from medial 2/3 of subscapular fossa of the scapula, inserts onto the lesser tubercle of the humerus. When it contracts, it causes medial rotation and adduction of the arm. It receives nerve supply from upper and lower subscapular nerves, which are branches of posterior cord of the brachial plexus. Moving on to the muscles seen on the dorsal aspect of scapular region. They are supraspinatus, which is seen above the spinous process of scapula. Infraspinatus is seen below the spinous process, whereas teres minor and teres major are seen along the lateral border of the scapula. Let's learn their further details. Let's learn the details of supraspinatus, infraspinatus and teres minor muscles together. Here is the supraspinatus muscle. It takes origin from medial 2/3 of supraspinous fossa of the scapula, whereas infraspinatus takes origin from medial 2/3 of infraspinous fossa of the scapula. Coming to the teres minor muscle, it takes origin from upper 2/3 of lateral border of the scapula from its dorsal surface. The fleshy fibers of 3 muscles converge laterally towards the greater tubercle of the humerus, where they get inserted in the form of a sheath-like tendon. Supraspinatus get inserted onto the upper impression, infraspinatus onto the middle impression and teres minor onto the lower impression of greater tubercle of the humerus. Such sheath-like tendon along with the tendon of subscapularis ventrally form rotator curve around the shoulder joint. Now let's see the actions of these muscles. When supraspinatus muscle contracts, it initiates the abduction till 15 degrees at shoulder joint. When infraspinatus and teres minor muscles contract, they together cause lateral rotation of the arm at shoulder joint. Let's understand this by looking at the following video clip. Here is the dorsal aspect of scapular region. Here is the supraspinatus muscle with its site of origin and its insertion. The muscle passes below the acromion process before it gets inserted and where it is related with subacromial bursa. When it contracts, it causes abduction till 15 degrees. Coming to the infraspinatus and teres minor muscles, here are their sites of origin and their insertions onto the greater tubercle. When they contract, they cause lateral rotation of the arm. The four muscles, subscapularis, supraspinatus, infraspinatus and teres minor muscles with their sheath-like tendon around the shoulder joint form rotator cuff. Now let's learn their nerve supply. Supraspinatus and infraspinatus muscles receive a branch from upper trunk of brachial plexus from Earp's point, that is suprascapular nerve, which enters the dorsal aspect of scapular region by passing through the suprascapular notch and sphenoglenoid notch. It ends by supplying these two muscles. Coming to the teres minor muscle, here it is. It receives a branch from posterior division of axillary nerve, which is a branch of posterior cord of the brachial plexus. Let's quickly revise the details of three muscles seen on the dorsal aspect of scapular region. Supraspinatus and infraspinatus muscles take origin from medial two-thirds of supraspinous fossa and infraspinous fossa of the scapula respectively, whereas teres minor takes origin from upper two-thirds of lateral border of the scapula. They get inserted along the upper impression, middle impression and lower impression on the greater tubercle of humerus, forming a continuous sheath-like tendon. Supraspinatus, when it contracts, it initiates the abduction till 15 degrees, whereas infraspinatus and teres minor muscles cause lateral rotation of the arm. They receive their nerve supply from suprascapular nerve, which supplies the supraspinatus and infraspinatus, whereas axillary nerve, it supplies the teres minor muscle through its posterior division. Let's learn about the teres major muscle. Here it is. It is the lowest muscle seen on the dorsal aspect of scapular region. It arises from lower one-third of lateral border of the scapula from its dorsal surface. Here is the teres major muscle, which gets inserted onto the medial lip of bicipital groove on the shaft of humerus. Coming to its actions, when it contracts, it causes adduction and medial rotation of the arm at shoulder joint, similar to the action of subscapularis muscle. Let's see these details in this video clip. Here is the muscle and here is its site of origin and insertion. It causes adduction and medial rotation of the arm. Now let's see its nerve supply. Here is the ventral view of axilla and here is the teres major muscle, which is forming the posterior wall of the axilla along with subscapularis and latissimus dorsi muscles. It receives its nerve supply from posterior cord of the brachial plexus through lower subscapular nerve, which also supplies subscapularis muscle. Let's quickly revise the details of teres major muscle. It arises from lower one-third of lateral border of the scapula from its dorsal surface. It gets inserted onto the medial lip of bicipital groove of the shaft of humerus. When it contracts, it causes medial rotation and adduction of the arm. It receives its nerve supply from lower subscapular nerve, which is a branch of posterior cord of brachial plexus. That is about the five muscles of scapular region. The points to be remembered here are: infraspinatus and teres minor muscles cause lateral rotation of the arm at shoulder joint, whereas teres major and subscapularis muscles cause medial rotation of the arm at shoulder joint. Here the supraspinatus and infraspinatus muscles are innervated by branch from upper trunk of brachial plexus, whereas teres minor, teres major and subscapularis muscles are innervated by branches from posterior cord of brachial plexus. Now it's time to learn about a muscle of deltoid region. Deltoid region, here it is. It covers the shoulder joint. And the only muscle which is get to see here is deltoid muscle. Here is its anterior view and here is the posterior view. It arises from three different sides so that it gives off three different sets of muscle fibers. They are anterior fibers, lateral fibers and posterior fibers. Anterior fibers take origin from anterior border and upper surface of lateral one-third of shaft of the clavicle, which is why they are also called as clavicular fibers. Lateral fibers take origin from lateral border of acromion process of scapula, which is why they are also called as acromial fibers. Whereas the posterior fibers take origin from lower lip of crest of spinous process of the scapula. Such muscle fibers converge laterally towards the shaft of humerus and they get inserted onto the deltoid tuberosity, which is a V-shaped roughened elevation at the middle one-third of lateral surface of shaft of the humerus. Now let's see the actions of different fibers of deltoid muscle. When anterior fibers contract, they cause flexion, adduction and medial rotation of the arm at shoulder joint. When posterior fibers contract, they cause extension, adduction and lateral rotation of the arm at shoulder joint. When lateral fibers contract, they cause abduction of the arm till 90 degrees at shoulder joint. Let's understand the origin, insertion and actions of the muscle by looking at the following video clip. Here is the deltoid muscle and here is its linear origin. Here is the insertion at deltoid tuberosity. Its anterior fibers are powerful flexors. Posterior fibers are extensors and lateral fibers are abductors of the arm at shoulder joint. The points to be noted here are: the anterior and posterior fibers are arranged as parallel bundles of muscle fibers as they are unipennate in origin, whereas lateral fibers are multipennate in origin, which is provided by the tendinous bands which arise from acromion process above and deltoid tuberosity from below. Let's understand this by looking at this image. Here are the lateral fibers which are reflected. What we are seeing here is the undersurface of acromial fibers. Here is the lateral border of acromion process of scapula, which gives attachment to four tendinous bands, which provide the extra surface for the origin of multipennate muscle fibers. Similarly, deltoid tuberosity gives attachment to three tendinous bands from below. Such pattern of lateral fibers or acromial fibers increases the force of contraction during the abduction. Now let's see the nerve supply of deltoid muscle. Here are the reflected lateral or acromial fibers of deltoid muscle. And here posterior fibers are removed. To see its nerve supply, that is axillary nerve, which is a branch of posterior cord of brachial plexus. It leaves the axilla by passing through the quadrangular space where it divides into anterior branch and posterior branch. The posterior branch supplies the posterior fibers of deltoid muscle along with the teres minor muscle, and the anterior branch supplies acromial fibers and clavicular fibers. Let's quickly revise the details of deltoid muscle. Its anterior fibers take origin from anterior border of lateral one-third of shaft of the clavicle. Lateral fibers take origin from lateral border of acromion process of scapula, which also give rise to four fibrous septae or tendinous bands from its four tubercles. Posterior fibers take origin from lower lip of crest of spinous process of the scapula. Such fibers insert onto the deltoid tuberosity of shaft of humerus, which also give rise to three fibrous septae. Coming to the actions of the muscle. When anterior or clavicular fibers contract, they cause adduction, flexion and medial rotation of the arm. And posterior fibers cause adduction, extension and lateral rotation of the arm. Whereas lateral fibers cause abduction of the arm till 90 degrees. Coming to its nerve supply. Deltoid is supplied by axillary nerve, which is a branch of posterior cord of brachial plexus. Here is the end of part 2, where we have learned about the muscles of scapular region and deltoid region. Thank you for your patient listening. Keep learning.